Decarbonization. It's a key factor in the fight against climate change. The goal is simple: to reduce carbon dioxide emissions around the world as soon as possible.
Our planet cannot be saved unless we leave fossil fuels in the ground where they belong.
Decarbonization requires both sweeping change and incremental steps, working industry by industry, process by process, in every major country in the world. Sound expensive? It will be. But the science community agrees that to avoid global catastrophe, we have no choice but to mobilize and take on this monumental challenge. Renewable energy, like wind turbines and solar panels, as well as electric cars, are the more popular topics in the conversation. But there are other key sectors that are less discussed, and changes there are equally important for decarbonizing the planet. Here's three: cement, steel, and agriculture. These three sectors combined make up almost 40% of all carbon emissions in the world. What will it take to revolutionize these three industries without bankrupting them? Cement is the most widely used man-made material in existence. When combined with water and aggregates, it can be poured into whatever shape is needed for construction. Cement has been used for millennia to build structures like the Pantheon and Roman aqueducts, to highways and parking garages. Lots of parking garages. Globally, the production of cement accounts for about 7% of yearly CO2 emissions. And that's largely because of how cement is created. The main ingredient to cement is a substance called clinker. In order to produce this, limestone is heated to high temperatures, and usually this heat is generated by fossil fuels, releasing CO2. Meanwhile, the chemical reactions inside the kiln release even more CO2 in the process. Companies are working to reduce the amount of clinker used. Others are testing substitutes, including fly ash, which is the residue left in chimneys of coal-burning furnaces, or slag from iron production. But the drawbacks are serious. These new techniques come with a price tag sometimes triple the cost of the traditional process. And since cement is holding many of the world's structures together, alternative recipes make contractors and regulators uneasy. Steel is just as important as cement, and as cities grow, global demand is expected to rise by 50% between 2019 and 2050. But its process involves purifying iron ore in blast furnaces with a refined form of coal called coke. And just like cement, this production produces a lot of CO2. In Europe, blast furnace owners are testing hydrogen as an alternative way to take the carbon out of iron ore. But again, so far it's way too expensive to go mainstream, about double the cost of using coke. There's one thing you can do with steel that you can't do with cement, and that is recycle. Instead of producing more steel in the first place, we can use what we already have. Increasing the use of steel recycling is now commonly seen as critical to reducing carbon emissions. Now, agriculture requires a multi-pronged effort, as it is responsible for nearly 25% of global CO2 emissions. The practice of controlled burns after harvests, the use of inorganic fertilizers that release methane and nitrous oxide into the air, the destruction of rainforests for ranching, and even livestock flatulence all need to be addressed to put a dent in agriculture's carbon output. Some hope can be seen in the U.S., as demands for beef products have dropped significantly. Additionally, interest in alternatives like Beyond Meat and Impossible Burgers have soared in recent years. And for those who can't quit beef, scientists are developing climate-proof cows with digestive systems that produce less methane. But implementing these solutions globally remains an uphill battle. Even as more people in Europe and the US take up vegetarian alternatives, increased meat demand in China and other developing nations means that globally, animal product consumption is expected to rise 60% by 2050.
You are the last best hope of Earth.
We are in the beginning of a mass extinction, and all you can talk about is money and fairy tales of eternal economic growth. How dare you?
It'll take policymakers and companies years of diligent work and collaboration to move industry away from its most polluting methods. But each of these industries is working on answers, with some executives confident they can be both green and show a profit.